And the title came about, it's a simple story actually. We were all literally in sort of Welsh borders in sitting down in our on our plush sofas. It's a very sort of basic place. And but we had had this fantastic new thing called a video player. And I think Roy, our producer, had got the Marx Brothers movie, A Night at the Opera. And I remember just sort of sitting down, we were settling down after dinner, you know, Saturday night, it was our night off, and we weren't going to do any more work. And Fred and I looked at one another and went, oh, it's a good title, because we'd just been doing this sort of mock operatic thing for Bohemian Rhapsody. And then I think everybody just sort of thought, yeah, good title. In those days, there were things called telexes, and Groucho telexed us. And so somebody set up a meeting and we were invited for lunch. So we went to Groucho Marx's house for lunch. Well, actually, three of us did, John chickened out. And he was a character. You know, he had the nurse there and he had the attractive nurse and the attractive manager. And then he suddenly had the attractive piano player and come in. And so he sang a couple of songs for us. Lydia, that encyclopedia, and something about a woman from Omaha. And then he said, well, you're singers, fucking sing. So and we went, oh, yeah. Oh, couldn't possibly, we don't have a guitar, you know, no instrument. He said, oh, no, we got one here. So they produced this Spanish guitar out of nowhere. So we sang 39 for Groucho Marx.